So how did it feel last week?
It was good. It was good to get back into game action and get up to speed and start to hit guys in different colored jerseys for a change.
And like, just in general, like getting back to here and playing and practicing and not having to deal with all the off-ice stuff, what's that been like for you? Has it helped to just kind of, you know, plow through?
Yeah, we're going to work every day and doing everything we can in our control and let the chips fall where they may. And I think it was a good start last game. I think created quite a few chances and couple tough bounces, but it should be on the score sheet and helping our team win. Nonetheless, we got the win against a team that was maybe more veteran, more established than we were, and speaks volumes to the guys that we had in the lineup of what they were willing to do.
What about the physicality? Were you a little surprised?
It's preseason, so you don't know what you're going to get, if guys are going to, you know, not necessarily go through the motions, but try to get up to speed, or if they're trying to rile up the roost and try to establish themselves. And I think certainly in the past it's been more of the latter, and more recently it's been more of the former, where it's guys, you know, more of a skill competition than it is a will competition. And that's just, you don't know what you're going to get, but you got to lay your game out there, whatever it is.
You look right now at the team in terms of doing a little piece on just center depth and how important that is, looking at all the previous champions in like the past 10 years, most of them are really deep up the middle. What's your take on how deep this team is in the center position?
It's as deep as of a team as I can remember, and you look through the top three, could be first line centers probably on most teams, and three first line centers is a good way to start, and then if it's Corrali or Parr or whoever it's going to be as a fourth line center, guys are going to get injured, who's stepping up, other guys that can play it, and Wags, and it bodes well for depth and being able to, because you're going to have some obstacles throughout the season with injuries or guys out, and be able to plug and play with whoever it's going to be next.
What did you notice when you first came up, if you can remember, when you first played center in the NHL versus maybe the league below or just playing at any other level? What was the difference?
I was kind of baptism by fire when I was a wing through college, and we were out of centers in St. Louis, and Andy Murray just said, "You're playing center tonight," and it was kind of learn or sink. And I had to learn, and certainly the workload that it creates for whoever's playing that position is much more than a winger, but you're responsible, you're engaged in the game all the time, you're taking the face-offs, and you're kind of the leader of that line, and that keeps you really centered and gives you ownership of what's going on out there, and it helped me a lot when I was younger in my career.
You bring up the word baptism by fire, and somebody else was talking about that. I mean, do you think it's better to do that as a young guy, or do you understand too why a coach might say, "I want to kind of ease him in on the wing and then get him there"?
Yeah, I think it's situational dependent of
the player.
Not force feeding him, the player's personality, and kind of where the team is. If your team's looking to make a deep run, you don't want a guy being baptized by fire, high in the lineup that's getting crushed every night. But if you're in a rebuild, the way that we were dead last in St. Louis, it was like there wasn't much to lose, and if it worked, you found something. So that was kind of situational dependent, and it turned out working all about right.
Yeah, because, I remember, when Sagan came in here his rookie year, the year they won the Cup, Claude was getting so bashed, why don't you just put this kid in the middle? Yeah. And he was kind of like, we're competing here. Right. So, you can kind of understand where the coach is coming from.
This isn't an experiment anymore. This is what works best for us to win now. And if it develops later, or he can learn on the fly, and just sitting on the bench watching a guy like Bergie can really teach a lot of things. So
it looks like it worked for him.
I think so. Yeah. He's doing all right.
Thanks, man.